Yo, everybody, what's going on? This is Keegan from K-Man Reviews. If you enjoyed this review, make sure you hit that like and the subscribe button. And if you have any opinions at all that you would like to share, make sure to leave them down in the comment section. Dr. Hook and the Medicine Show. Dr. Hook and the Medicine Show were an American rock band formed in 1968, but didn't really start releasing any music until the 70s. After that, the band would see 8 consecutive years of regular chart success, most notably with their later material under the shortened moniker of just Dr. Hook. However, I'm personally much more nostalgic for their earlier material, the folky, country-esque ballads that got them on the map. Songs like Cover of the Rolling Stone, Queen of the Silver Dollar, Freakin' at the Freakers Ball, and one of their biggest hits from this era, Sylvia's Mother, which is on this album that I'm reviewing today, the debut album, simply titled Dr. Hook, released in 1972. And let's just jump right in. What are my thoughts on Dr. Hook? Let's find out as I review this album, track by track. We will start with the singles, with there being just the one of them, that being the opener, Sylvia's Mother, which I couldn't hate the song even if I tried to. Certainly isn't the most energetic opener out there, but it opens sweet enough with some light, folky guitar work and a gentle, rattling percussion accompanied by a soft violin as it builds to this iconic, harmonizing chorus that wisps me right back to childhood road trips. A simple harmonica gets added for the second verse as Dennis's vocals gradually get more and more desperate and frantic as the track goes on, perfectly fitting these lyrics about this guy trying to get in touch with Sylvia, with whom he had a previous relationship with, calling her from a payphone as her mother, Mrs. Avery, picks up, and informs our protagonist that Sylvia is engaged and heading off to Galveston, Texas for marriage. The mother eventually starts to get emotional and thanks the unnamed narrator for calling in the first place. Apparently, this song was also based on a true story from lead songwriter for this album, Shel Silverstein, almost to a T as well, which it's just an all-around classic tune. Now for the rest of the tracks. Marie Laveau, which most people may know from the Bobby Bear version, but this one is the first known recording of the song, and this is a complete 180 from Sylvia's Mother. The instrumental has a bit of funk to it. I love the grungy bass, the guitar work is plucky and raunchy. The percussion is minimal, but it does a good job to give the song a steady beat. However, the showstopper is the vocals here. Both vocalists actually get a chance to sing on the song, and they're both polar opposites. Dennis has a bit more of a chill, smooth voice, while Ray has a very shrill, crackly southern accent that lets loose a discordant screech on the chorus, which definitely caught me off guard a few times, but after looking at the lyrics, I absolutely love it and understand it now. It's about a voodoo-practicing witch named Marie Laveau and a bystander named Handsome Jack, where Jack offers a deal to Marie. If she conjures him up $1 million, he'll marry her. She obliges, and Jack steps out of the deal, proclaiming her to be too ugly for him, to which she lets out a horrific screech which causes people to disappear, and such was the fate of Handsome Jack. Wasn't crazy about this one on first listen, but after a while, I've come to love it. Sing Me a Rainbow has a very similar feeling to Sylvia's Mother in more ways than one. Dennis sings in a pretty samey way to that song. He's got a light, quivery, yet very full voice that can make his words resonate a lot more than they could otherwise. The vocal melody itself feels kind of similar as well, especially on the verses, but the instrumental is much more rich and lively as well, with a more upbeat guitar. The strings are more delicate and impactful, and the chorus is monumental. It really soars with some satisfying harmonies. Lyrically, the track seems to be about going through a rough day and asking this significant other of his to sing him into a peaceful state, get his head back on straight. Good song here. Hey Lady Godiva, the shortest track on this album at 2 minutes and 17 seconds, and this one's pretty good as well. It's got a honky-tonk rhythm to it, the clap beats, the buttery bass work, light shakers, and an immaculate trumpet performance, especially for the solo. Ray returns on this one vocally, and I think he does a great job here and fits very well, which I'll explain why in a bit. However, I'm especially disappointed here that there was no soaring or energetic climax to the track aside from the trumpet solo. It's a pretty mid-tempo song all around, but thankfully it is short, so it's not too hindering, but the lyrical content more than makes up for it, telling the story of Lady Godiva as she rides naked on her white horse throughout the town. I love the way the song's worked, and the vocals only make it better with the goofy, exaggerated performance. Pretty good song as well. 4 years Older Than Me instantly catches me with this dirty, repetitive riff that just continues through the entire song as it's assisted by some killer drum work, another harmonica, a subtle shaker, and some other guitar embellishments. It's a lumbering, hypnotic groove that really helps with Dennis's more twangy vocals, but the change really does suit him. especially when it comes to these muddier instrumentals. He really lets his manic side unleash on the second half of the tune, almost going full-blown Joker for the bridge with a psychotic laugh, as these lyrics are pretty self-explanatory. 17-year-old narrator looking for a woman on his birthday. He's got a pocket full of money, stole his dad's car, picked up a woman who's 4 years older than him, then went back to her place and scored. What a true hero. Jokes aside though, I think this is one of the catchier and more fun tracks on the album. Kiss It Away is really just an acoustic ballad, that's all you get. No percussion, no solos, no quirky additions, just a melancholic acoustic guitar that constantly fades in and out of prominence. Dennis's vocals are the star of the show as a result, starting off gentle and typical for the genre, but gradually becoming more and more distraught as the song goes on, so much so that by the end, he actually breaks down in tears and weeps in silence. It almost feels like the song comes from a place of genuine heartbreak, which I couldn't confirm. Maybe it's all just an act, and if so, it's pretty convincing. Lyrically, it seems to tackle the deterioration of this relationship and how there's so many rainy days now, much more so than there was before. The sun doesn't even seem to show itself anymore, and he's just asking to kiss away his pain. Normally, I wouldn't make too much of this, but the performance of this song is very gripping and makes the song feel like so much more. Making It Natural is probably the closest we get to a tried-and-true country song on the album. The pecking of the guitar, the slow, simple bass work, the drums, the claps, there's even some nice keys in there that add a lush layer to the track, along with some background harmonizers and a satisfying guitar solo. Ray's got a pretty good vocal presence on here. It's a little bit silly, kind of playful, as he sings these lyrics about ditching drugs and marijuana for the drug that is love. Pretty simple song, but it does its job well. Good stuff. I Call That True Love brings back Ray's gritty and hoarse vocals, and I think out of all the songs they're on, this is probably the one that feels the most out of place and kind of hinders the song as a result, especially since they have a little bit of a slurring to them. The other tracks that they were featured on have a little bit of a gimmick and a lot more humor in them. The humor on this one is pretty dry and doesn't have the same silly undertone like Hey Lady Godiva or Marie Laveau did. The instrumental here is pretty solid though. I like the heavy bass, the stomping percussion, snaps, and the harmonica adds a nice bit of blues to the track, but to me, it's really the vocals that sour the song, and the lyrics don't do much to justify it at all. Basically romanticizing this relationship like he's being pampered by this woman, treating him to fine dining, massages, and how he isn't getting that, but it sure is the love he needs. Yeah, this is a pass. When She Cries is a tender-hearted ballad and a total shift in tone from I Call That True Love, and this is just such a beautiful song. The instrumental is unsurprisingly sparse, the piano and guitar duet together for the majority of the song as Dennis's vibrato elegantly dances to the tune. The chorus brings in some rich and dense harmonies, really feels like the emotional climax of the song. It's so powerful compared to the dismal verses. Lyrically, the track comes after this relationship's fallout, how he knows what this woman's laughter, smiles, her love and personality are, and hopes this new partner treasures them well, but simply asks them to return her to him when she cries, as he knows how to mend that side of her. Love this one, can't say enough good things about it. Judy is an upbeat folk banger. This is an amazing song. The verses start the song on an instantly catchy note. The guitar has a blissfully positive tone to it. I love the fragile rattle of the cymbals, and Dennis's carefree, casual vocals accentuate the recollection of events that is the first verse. The rest of the song continues this vibe to a T. It feels very effortless as the guitar gets a bit more intense, as do Dennis's vocals, a dynamic he really seems to enjoy doing. I do like the lyrics as well, how our protagonist is long past a relationship and admits back then he wasn't the best romantic partner in the world, and in the years since, he's been learning a lot about himself and seems to be moving in a positive direction. Great track here. And finally, the closer, Mama, I'll Sing One Song For You, opens up with this spoken word passage over harmonica that kind of makes me think it's going to be one of those songs in the style you see in prison movies where it's just one guy and his harmonica playing a bluesy ditty. But thankfully, the guitar comes in after that introduction with the same breezy quality. Yet, especially in a track as sentimental as this one, it doesn't feel old at all. In fact, it feels like one of the most passionate songs on the album, with the skipping percussion and gorgeous harmonies, as these lyrics are just so sweet about this singer and his mama. How mom wishes she could have her boy just stay at home, but she knows he's a traveling man, and he has to leave the nest. But deep down, the singer never forgot any of the memories with mama, dedicating this song to her out of love. Very nice way to close off the album. Overall, I'm not gonna lie, I kinda just expected this to mainly be Sylvia's Mother plus some clones and a bunch of filler tracks. But to my surprise, this was an engaging ride of a record with different genres, different tones, plenty of different topics, an album I did not expect to like as much as I did. Very emotive performances across this album keep it from becoming too stale, often sweet instrumentation. Sure, it may be labeled as dad rock, but fuck it, it's good music. I liked it a lot. I'm feeling an 8.5 out of 10 on this album. Well guys, hope you enjoyed that review. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.